Welcome to the Advanced Brain Monitoring X-Series EEG Wireless System Training Video. This standard training video will cover an introduction to ABM system, preparation for an acquisition, application of sensors, how to check impedances, troubleshooting and tips, and cleanup and storage. ABM's X-Series system is marketed as a medical device under the STAT brand and as a consumer device under the B-Alert brand. Both STAT and B-Alert systems function the same way. ABM systems use a special adapter that connects the headset to the sensor strip, allowing for different acquisition montages. Although there are some nuances between the different acquisition montages, the general setup is the same. This training is for linked mastoid montages, both the standard 1020 linked mastoid and 1020 reduced linked mastoid. The 1020 reduced setup uses the same strip as the standard 1020, but fewer sensor sites are used for EEG acquisition. Before performing an acquisition, refer to the hardware technical manual to ensure that you have received all necessary equipment and make sure your headset is fully charged. Please note that scissors and 70% isopropyl alcohol wipes are also necessary. However, these are not included with your ABM system. We suggest you purchase large, sturdy alcohol wipes as they provide the best results. Before you begin a setup, take note of the following. Practice setting up and familiarizing yourself with the system. Learning the system on official subjects is not recommended. Modifications to instructions may lead to negative effects on system performance. To select the appropriate strip size for a subject, you will need to take three measurements. First, with the subject seated, locate the inion, which is the protruding bump on the occipital bone at the back of the head. Ask the subject to look up slightly and, starting at the nape of the neck, slowly walk your fingers from the bottom of the subject's head upwards until you have reached the slight bump at the back of the skull. The bump will vary in prominence and size across subjects and is typically less pronounced in females. Next, locate the subject's nasion, which is the depressed area directly between the eyes and just above the bridge of the nose. Take the provided measuring tape and measure in centimeters from the nasion over the midline of the subject's head, ending at the bottom of the inion. Pull the tape tautly, especially if the subject has a lot of hair. Failure to do so will give you a false measurement, potentially leading to an incorrect strip size. Make note of the center point of this measurement, as you will use that center spot in the next measurement. Record the value. Next, measure laterally from the top of ear attachment on one side of the head to the top of ear attachment on the other side of the head, running the tape over the center point from the previous measurement. Record the value. Then, measure the circumference. Ask the subject to look up slightly and line the tape up just above the eyebrows. It may be helpful to ask the subject to place their finger on the tape to prevent it from moving. Wrap the tape around the head right above the ear attachment and connect just above the inion. Record the value. Use the strip sizing chart provided with your system to determine the appropriate strip size. Find the recorded nasion to inion value on the y-axis and the top of ear attachment value on the x-axis. Locate the point where the two values intersect to identify the subject's appropriate strip size. Some head shapes and sizes may require an adjustment. For medium head sizes with a circumference less than 56 centimeters, downsize to a small strip. For small head sizes with a circumference less than 52 centimeters, downsize to an extra small strip. Lay the strip on a flat surface, label side up. Confirm the strip size. Check the strip for any damages, such as creases or tears. Remove the adapter cover. It may be easier to detach the cover clips one side at a time. Confirm that the adapter type matches your required strip montage. Please be aware that ABM has different adapters for different montages. Insert the strip tail into the connector until you feel a slight snap. The strip is fully seated if the holes on the strip tail line up with the adapter posts. Once the strip is seated, place the cover back on the adapter. Align the label markings on the adapter cover with the strip. Press firmly to snap into place. The cover should seat fully on the bottom. If the cover does not seat fully, check to see if you have inserted the strip correctly. Flip the adapter and strip over so the strip labeling is not seen and the foam donuts are face up. Please note, the four sensors on the forehead do not have the foam centers removed. This is for additional comfort. Place the head strap with the looped or fuzzy side of the strap facing down. With the strip still facing label side down, carefully feed the triangular tip of the strap through the hole on the front of the strip. center the strip on the strap and firmly press the Velcro down as straight as possible to set its position. Once the strip is secured to the strap, unfold the Velcro side of the strap and feed it through the appropriate slot on the strip. Tip the barbell side of the strap and insert one side of the barbell before pulling the strap through. Folding the strap before passing it through the strip slot may cause damage. Next, fill the foam donuts with EEG Connect. Saturate the foam by gently pressing and swiping each sensor site to allow the foam to absorb as much cream as possible. Refill the donuts. You may need to repeat these steps to fully saturate the foam, but be careful not to overfill the donuts and cause the cream to squish outside of the foam. Please note, the 10-20 reduced adapter only allows EEG acquisition from 9 sites. Do not apply cream to any of the frontal sites along the strap, or to the T5, T6, and O1, O2, which are the sensors on the last arm furthest from the strap. We recommend requesting the subject have clean hair without any hair products for the acquisition session. Hair products are a major cause of high impedances. However, even without products, the head must be thoroughly cleaned. The alcohol wipe is used to remove natural oils, dirt, and hair product residue. This helps to reduce impedance values between the scalp and sensor sites. We recommend using large, sturdy 70% isopropyl alcohol wipes. Wipe the forehead and mastoid bones behind the ears with pressure similar to washing your face. Then, wipe down the subject's head, scrubbing with pressure similar to shampooing your hair and getting all the way down to scalp. Take care not to cause physical distress to the participant. Before continuing, ensure that the skin has dried. Next, apply electrodes to the mastoids or A1, A2 sites. For easier placement and improved subject comfort, use scissors to cut down the size of the two adhesive electrodes. It is recommended to prepare these in advance and have them ready before the subject arrives. Apply a small dab of cream on the center of the electrode. Spread it out evenly. Peel the paper backing off the electrode to expose the adhesive. Then apply the electrodes to both mastoid sites. Avoid getting any of the cream on the adhesive area. Proper placement is critical, so take care to feel for the bony area behind the ear. Avoid the hair and muscle for optimal data quality and comfort. Be careful not to place the electrodes too close to where the strap will sit or right up against the ear. Hold both arms of the strap in one hand and the adapter in the other. Hand the adapter to the subject and instruct them to look up slightly and hold the adapter at eye level away from their face. Using both hands, hold both sides of the neoprene strap with the plastic ends of the strip. Stand behind the subject. Place the strip and strap on the subject's head just above the eyebrows. Align the triangular piece of the neoprene strap between the subject's eyes and fasten around the circumference of the subject's head. Tighten the strap to a comfortable and snug fit. Check that both sides of the strap sit just above the top of the subject's ears and the triangular tab is centered between the subject's eyes. Tuck one or two fingers in between the strip and strap just in front of the ear. The strap should feel snug. Ask the subject if the fit is comfortable. Tell them it should be snug, but not too tight, similar to the fit of a bicycle helmet. Fit is especially important for longer studies. Next, take the adapter from the subject and bring it up and over the top of their head. Ask the subject to press their fingers on the strap into their forehead to keep it from moving. If your participant has long hair, be sure to view the Tips and Techniques module as the next steps will vary slightly. Walk your fingers down the strip on the center line of the head, keeping the strip taut. Make sure not to pull on the strip so hard that it rises on the subject's forehead. Lightly fasten the two furthest back strip arms down onto the strap at the same time. This will keep the strip centered and in place while you check the temporal sensors. To ensure low impedance values, gently pull back the top of the strap to view the frontal sensors along the forehead and temple where there is hair. Use the curved tip of the cream tube to part any hair and expose the scalp to the foam sensors as needed. Refill the foam with cream for the sensors that are not directly on the forehead. Please note, if you are using the 10-20 reduced adapter, do not fill the frontal sights. Next, begin lightly fastening the strip's arms to the neoprene strap. Start from the front and move toward the back. Fasten the pair of arms at the same time with the same amount of pressure. The ideal fit of the strip is achieved when all arms converge just anterior or just in front of the ear and below the strap. The foam sensors should lay flat against the subject's head. If the strip arms do not reach the strap, it is possible that the strip is too small. If the strip arms fall below the strap, it may be that the strip is too big for the participant. For the third arms and the P3, P4 sites, prioritize flat sensor placement rather than converging at the correct spot. If needed, move the arms slightly forward or backwards to find the best fit, ensuring flat sensors. It is now time to refill and position the remaining foam sensors on top of parted hair to give the best scalp to sensor connection. One at a time, working front to back, lift each strip arm. When lifting the strip arms, hold the bottom of the strap and peel the arm off the neoprene to help the Velcro release and keep the strip from moving out of place. Fill the donut hole with cream. Part the hair and lay the sensor down directly on the cleared scalp for the best connection. Once all the strip arms are fastened to the strap, ensure that all foam sensors are lying flat against the head and are slightly compressed. Please note that excessive pressure can have negative effects on both signal quality and subject comfort. If the 3-pin cables are not already connected to the headset, connect them to the 3-pin connector. If you are using the ECG leads and the 2-pin cables are not already connected to the headset, connect them to the 2-pin connector opposite the 3-pin connector. You are now ready to connect the headset. With the headset label side down in your hand, press your thumb in the middle of the door, then slide open the two latches and remove the door. Make sure the slide locks are fully open before removing the door, or it may cause damage to the locks. Hold the headset with the STAT X24 label facing you. Align the adapter board with the underside of the headset. Carefully and firmly connect the two pieces. Flip the headset over. Replace the door. Press in the center of the door and slide the locks closed. If the door does not already have the small neoprene strap attached, slip it through the transparent plastic loop with the fuzzy or Velcro side facing away from the headset. Holding the two ends of the small strap, flip the headset downward so it is right side up. Attach the Velcro on the headset to the neoprene strap on the subject's head. Snap the 3-pin leads to the electrodes behind the subject's ears. Connect the black snap to the left side, A1, and the red snap to the right side, A2. A good way to remember the side-dependent connector placement is with a mnemonic device. Both black and left have the letter L for the left side. Both red and right have the letter R for the right side. If you are using the ECG leads, ask the subject to wipe their clavicle or collarbone on their left and right side with an alcohol swab. Allow the skin to dry. Snap adhesive electrodes to the end of the ECG lead cables. Beginning with the lead connector colored blue, attach the electrode to the subject's left clavicle or collarbone. Then, with the lead connector colored gray, attach the electrode to the subject's right clavicle. Remember, both blue and left have the letter L for the left side. Likewise, both gray and right have the letter R for the right side. Attach your system's Bluetooth receiver to the USB port on the computer you will be using to acquire data. Turn the headset on by pressing the button located on the top left corner of the headset. The indicator on the receiver will change from a blinking light to a solid light once the headset has established connection. Performing an impedance check is a systematic method to ensure good contact across all sensor sites. Impedance measures the amount of resistance at each sensor site and is presented in kilo-ohms. Lower values reflect better connections. Higher values, or values out of range, means there is a poor connection or the connection is non-existent. Refer to software instructions for more details on how to start an impedance check with your specific acquisition software. ABM's acquisition software are designed to provide color-coded guidance for sensor connectivity. Red signifies values above 80 kilo-ohms, yellow if between 40 and 80 kilo-ohms, and green if less than 40 kilo-ohms. Reference impedances depend on the specific strip that you are using. For the 10 to 20 lm or linked mastoid and 10 to 20 lm reduced strips, reference impedances are measured at A1, A2, the mastoid sites. For quality data, ABM recommends that impedance values for all sensor sites are lower than 40 kilo-ohms or green before proceeding with the data acquisition. Some potential issues that you may experience include high impedance values for all channels or high impedance values for only some of the channels. Please be aware that impedances typically drop slightly over time. So if the impedance check reflected values just slightly over 40 kilo-ohms, giving the strip time to settle may be more effective than actively troubleshooting the strip. For high impedance values across all channels, first check the reference impedance to see if it is less than 20 kiloohms. A slightly higher value is acceptable if the mastoid electrodes were just placed on the subject. However, if the reference impedance is high, it will negatively impact all channels. If the reference impedance is high, remove the adhesive electrodes. Use a paper towel to wipe away any residual cream. Rewipe the mastoid area with an alcohol swab and allow the skin to dry. Reapply new electrodes. Make sure that the electrodes have a small dab of cream in the center and that the site is clear of any hair before reapplying to the mastoid. Rerun an impedance check and make sure the reference impedance has come down. If high impedances persist for all channels, it may be more efficient to remove the strip and start over again, paying close attention to thorough cleaning of the head, forehead, and mastoid sites with alcohol wipes. Not cleaning the head thoroughly enough is the most common reason for poor impedances. To address high impedances for only some sensors that persist, locate the specific channels that appear red or yellow on the impedance check. Lift the strip arm, if necessary, to access the sensor and add more cream. Use the tip to part the hair and expose the scalp where the sensor rests. Reattach the strip arm, ensure it lays flat and the foam is compressed. If after multiple failed attempts, the impedances still are not within range, wipe the site thoroughly with a damp paper towel, then an alcohol wipe. Then reapply cream to the foam donut. Please remember the following. Make sensor scalp connection by parting hair and adding cream. Ensure foam sensor compression by ensuring the strip arms are flat. Using the incorrect strip size may cause gaps between the sensor and the scalp. Impedances will go down over time with good connection and compression. If impedances are not going down, spot clean the sensor sites. A thorough cleaning of the subject's head is key to good impedances. If all troubleshooting attempts fail, the sensor strip may be damaged. Clean the head and start with a fresh strip. When acquisition testing is complete, turn the headset off. Carefully remove the adhesive sensors from the ECG clavicle sites if used, and mastoid sites, or ask subjects to remove them for personal comfort. Unfasten the Velcro tabs that attach the headset to the neoprene head strap and tuck the tabs in so that they stick to the small strap. Detach all strip arms tabs from the neoprene strap, starting from the back and working to the front. Unfasten the Velcro on the strap and lift the strip away from the subject, being careful not to let the headset or cables hit the participant. Using a damp paper towel, wipe away any residual cream from the subject's head. Do not use alcohol wipes for cleaning up the subject, as it will cause the cream to become stickier and more difficult to remove. Take care not to cause physical distress to the participant. With the headset label side up on a flat surface, remove the adapter board cover. Lift the strip slightly so that it clears the posts on the adapter board and pull the strip out of the connector. Replace the adapter cover. Discard the entire strip, including the head strap. Unsnap electrodes from the cables and dispose. To clean the device, remove the small neoprene strap from the headset door. Wipe down the device and cables with an alcohol wipe. Wipe the small neoprene strap with an alcohol wipe and slip it back through the transparent plastic loop with the fuzzy or Velcro side facing away from the headset. Gently wind the cables and place them on top of the headset in the system case. Do not wind the cables around the headset as it may damage them. You may want to prepare the system for the next use by ensuring that your headset is fully charged before storing.